Hello everyone! Welcome to our Financial Solutions Today YouTube channel. Okay, don't forget to click subscribe and the bell button so you will always be notified with our new session or our new topic. And also click like, click share. Okay, share this to the people that you know. So right now we are going to learn about four things that you need to know about financial planning. So first and foremost, in Jeremiah 29:11, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." Especially right now in the midst of this pandemic, it's very important. It's very important that you know that God has a great plan in our life. We have to know exactly the plan that God is putting in our heart, okay? So again, so how are you going to really work on that plan? So these are the four things, okay, that we have to consider. Number one, know what you want, okay? It's all about what we want in life, okay? And we have to make sure we understand what we really want in our life. Remember, God has a great plan in your life, but you have to know exactly what you want in life. Do you plan to do something special with your life? Do you know the reason why you want to prosper? Do you know the reason why you want to go into the business? What difference you can make to the people that you care, to your kids, your spouse, your parents? You see, life is 90% why and only 10% how. Very important that we know exactly what we want in life and why we want it, okay? We have to have a clear goal at a specific time. How much money do you want to make? How soon you want to become financially independent? Imagine if a travel agent asks you where and when you want to travel, and your answer is any destination is okay and any time is fine with me. Pwede ba yon? But it's your life. Be specific on what you want and when you want to achieve it. Do you want a comfortable retirement? Do you want your children's education, healthcare for retirement, fun parents retirement, see the world and travel, pay off your debt, dream house, dream car, church, helping the church, okay, capital for business. So what do you want in life? So for example, everybody can desire something. For example, if you ask a person who wants to have a car, everybody will probably raise their hand, both their hands and both of their feet, okay, and they are so excited, I want to have that car. But not everybody will probably have that car. We have to be specific, okay? We have to go into the details. The more detailed you are to your goal, the closer you are in achieving it. Like, you want to have a car. What type of car? What model? How much is that car? Have you ever been into a showroom? Well, have you ever acquired a driver's license? Do you know how to drive? Have you been into a driving school? So you have to be specific in accomplishing what you want in life. So that's the number one, very important. Know what you want, and you have to be specific, and you need to go to details on what you want in life. The second thing is know how to get what you want. Deuteronomy 8:18, okay, remember the Lord your God, it is He who gives you the ability to produce wealth. So first and foremost, when God gave you a plan, you have to understand He is going to give you the ability to accomplish it. That's why God has one question to you. What is in your hand? You just present to God all the resources right now that you have in life, and God will give you the ability. He has the ability to make it grow and multiply. For example, you want to have a dream house. And your dream house will cost you probably, let's say, just 2 million pesos. And you want the dream house in 5 years. So how much money do you need? So you have to know exactly how to get what you want in life. So meaning, if you save, let's say you save 20,000 pesos a month and you put it at 12%, then 20,000 in 5 years, then you will have 2 million pesos. But the question is, do you have 20,000 a month? What if you only have 5,000 pesos a month? So what will you do? Either you shrink your dream, okay, to meet the size of your income, or you do something to increase your income to meet the size of your dream. So if you are lacking 15,000, then you have to do something. You need to do something about it. Like, probably you need to start a business. Probably you need to earn more income, okay, to get what you want in life. That's why there is what we call insanity. So the best definition of insanity is doing things again and again and again and expecting different results. If you want to change where you are going, you need to change also what you are doing. If in the last 5 years you were not able to get your dream house, then you need to do something, okay, to accomplish it. So that's two things already. Number one, know what you want. Number two, know how to get what you want. Number three, know yourself. Do you have what it takes to win? Know if you can get what you want with what you have right now. Can you achieve what you want with what you have right now? Can you get what you want by just working for someone else? Okay, so probably you need to really change what you are doing. Romans chapter 5 verses 3 to 5, it says we can rejoice too when we run into problems and trials, for we know that they help us develop endurance, and endurance develops strength of character, and character strengthens our confident hope of salvation, and this hope will never lead us to disappointment. That's the number three things that we have to understand. Know yourself. When we have the right attitude, whatever it takes attitude, failure is never fatal nor final. Okay, only quitting is final. Know your weakness. Procrastination, fear of rejection, shyness, we need to conquer them. Know your strength. Positive attitude, mental toughness, perseverance, and improve them. Know the price we have to pay for the sacrifices you're willing to make to get what you want in life in order for you to win. Determine exactly what you intend to give in return for the income that you desire. There's no such thing as something for free. Know what it will take for you to win. Proverbs 24:16, though a righteous man falls 7 times, he rises again, but the wicked are brought down by calamity. So we have to keep on fighting for our goals. We need to keep on believing that God will provide. All the top 20 billionaires in the world are business owners. 13 out of 20 are self-made billionaires, and the remaining 7 inherited it. Get a job, you make a living. Get a business, you make a fortune. So if you know that you are not going to get what you want by the job that you have, then probably you need to start another business. Okay, you need to have another source of income. We cannot depend on a single source of income, more so on that so-called job. So what do we mean by job? The J-O-B, that's the journey of the broke. So the three things already. Number one, know what you want. Number two, know how to get what you want. Number three, know yourself. Number four, know that you are going to win. When God placed something in your heart, okay, when God placed that goals, that vision in your heart, make sure you know that God will fulfill it. Make sure you know you're going to win. Because if you don't, you might as well quit. Now, Proverbs 29:18, when there is no vision, my people perish. So you have to make sure that you receive the revelation from the Lord so that you will keep on believing that no matter what happened, God will fulfill that plan that He has placed in your life. Okay? Don't believe your doubt and don't doubt your belief. Because when you believe your doubt and you doubt your belief, it kills your dream. Doubt is the enemy assigned to throw off God's perfect timing. Hebrews 6:12, we do not want you to become lazy, but to imitate those who through faith and patience inherit what has been promised. How are you going to get what you want in life? Through faith and patience. Just keep believing. God's timing is always the right time, no matter what. Okay? Even we are in the midst of this chaos, in this pandemic crisis, of the COVID-19 crisis, you have to understand God is going to fulfill that plan that He has placed in your heart. James chapter 1 verses 5 to 7, it says, if any of you lack wisdom, he should ask God, who give generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to him. But when he asks, he must believe and not doubt. Because if you doubt, you are like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That man should not think he will receive anything from the Lord. Doubt is the vehicle that leads us down to the road of poverty. So nothing can hold us back. If you have to keep on fighting for your goals, you need to keep on doing it, okay? You need to keep on focusing to accomplish that goals that God placed in your life. In Psalm 92:12, it says, the righteous will flourish like a palm tree. They will grow like a cedar of Lebanon. Have you ever seen a palm tree? A palm tree is hit by a typhoon or a big storm. Okay, it almost kissed the ground as it is almost dead. But once the storm is over, once the storm calmed down, you would notice the palm tree goes back to the original position. You see, nothing comes easy in life. We will all experience problems. We will all experience challenges. We will all experience difficulties. But it's not about the problem. It's not about the circumstances. It's not about the difficulties. It's how we respond. If we know that God has placed that plan, that goals in our life, we will keep fighting for it. Habakkuk 2:3 says, the vision is for a future time. It describes the end. It will be fulfilled. Okay? It may seem slow in coming, but wait patiently, for it will surely take place. It will never be delayed. So we just need to put our whole trust to God, that whatever things that you, whatever plans that He has placed in your life, is going to fulfill that in your life. So what are these four things again? Okay, in order for us to really succeed in our life, number one, know what you want. Number two, know how to get what you want. Number three, know yourself. And number four, know that you are going to win. I hope that you learned something from our topic today. Don't forget to click subscribe and click the bell button so you will always be notified if we have a new topic. Thank you very much. God bless us all.